person we celebrate God's grace this day. I'm Reverend Charles Uhlik, rector and pastor here, and also today on this festival day we are commemorating the Apostle Bartholomew. Let us open our Books of Common Prayer on page 355, page 355. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Page 356. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our colic prayer can be found at the top of the our readings for this day. Almighty and everlasting God, who gave to your apostle Bartholomew grace truly to believe and to preach your word, grant that your church may love what he believed and preach what he taught. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated as we hear God's sacred word. Our reader today is Deacon Becky Brooks.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 9 through 15. For I think that God has exhibited us apostles as last of all, as though sentenced to death, because we have become a spectacle to the world, to angels and to mortals. We are fools for the sake of Christ, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are held in honor, but we in disrepute. To the present hour, we are hungry and thirsty. We are poorly clothed and beaten and homeless, and we grow weary from the work of our hands. When reviled, we bless. When persecuted, we endure. When slandered, we speak kindly. We have become like rubbish of the world, the dregs of all things to this very day. I am not writing this to make you ashamed, but to admonish you as my beloved children. For though you might have 10,000 guardians in Christ, you do not have many fathers. Indeed, in Christ Jesus, I become your father through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm appointed for today is Psalm 91. We shall read it by half verse, alternating. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High
abides under the shadow of the Almighty.
He shall say to the Lord, you are my refuge and my stronghold.
My God, in whom I put my trust.
He shall deliver you from the snare of the hunter.
From the deadly pestilence.
He shall cover you with his pinions, and you shall find refuge under his wings.
His faithfulness shall be a shield and buckler.
You shall not be afraid of any terror by night,
nor the arrow that flies by day,
of the plague that stalks in the darkness,
nor the sickness that lays waste at midday.
1,000 shall fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand.
But it shall not come near you.
Your eyes have only to behold.
See the reward of the wicked.
Because you have made the Lord your refuge.
And the Most High your habitation.
There shall no evil happen to you.
Neither shall any plague come near your dwelling.
For he shall give his angels charge over you.
To keep you in all your ways.
They shall bear you in their hands.
Lest you dash your foot against a stone.
You shall tread upon the lion and adder.
You shall trample the young lion and the serpent under your feet.
Because he is bound to me in love, therefore will I deliver him.
I will protect him.
He shall call upon me, and I will answer.
I am with him in trouble. I will rescue him and bring him to honor.
With long life will I satisfy him.
And show him my salvation. A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
From chapter 22, verses 24 through 30. A dispute also arose among them as to which one of them was to be regarded as the greatest. But he said to them, "The kings of the Gentiles lord it over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors. But not so with you. Rather, the greatest among you must become like the youngest, and the leader like one who serves. For one is greater, the other is at table, or the one who serves. Is it not that the one at table? But I am among you as one who serves. You are those who have stood by me in my trials. And I confer on you, just as my Father has conferred on me, a kingdom, so that you may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom. And you will sit on the thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
May what I am about to say be in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. Today we are celebrating the Apostle Bartholomew. Now, in the Synoptic Gospels, which are Matthew, Mark, Luke, and in the Acts of the Apostles, they're paired with Philip and James and Bartholomew. In those scriptures, we have them being named together. But in the Gospel of John, there is no mention of Bartholomew. We have possibly two other areas that are referred to by John, the gospel writer John, as being Bartholomew as is part of relationship to Tomali, who was the historical writer named Nathaniel. So because his name was Nathaniel, we have the ideas that Nathaniel was paired because referred to Philip being a follower of Jesus Christ. And so because of that, we have a connection that Bartholomew most likely was also a follower because of the relationship with Philip. We know very little more than that about Bartholomew, but what we do know is that he did take the place of Judas Iscariot, who took his own life after betraying our Lord Jesus Christ. Bartholomew was selected by this rolling of dice, also said. And that because of that, he was selected as the person to fill the position as an apostle. What we do know about Bartholomew in his later ministry was that he probably went to Persia and was their martyr for the faith. His most famous depiction is in the Sistine Chapel, where Michelangelo depicts the ideas of the kingdom of heaven and hell and of earth on the Sistine Chapel wall behind the main high altar. He is located in the lower right-hand corner as you're looking at the portrait. I believe he is holding a filleting knife. And in the other hand, he was thought to be martyred by that of taking his skin to him in the Persia, now India. We know that he took his ministry. As we listen to our scriptures today, though, it is given to us as an apostle is that we go and teach the faith. Because Bartholomew had the courage with Philip to go to these areas and to tell people of who Jesus was, we'll find people who are accepting and those who are not accepting. Strange, we still have that same understanding with humanity today. There are many corners of our world that Christians are still persecuted. Many places that the word of God, of a Christian, of the name of Jesus Christ, is also still persecuted. Many of those places are in countries where there is only one leader, and it is run by a dictator. Bartholomew is an encouragement for all Christians to spread the good news of Jesus Christ today. As in our psalmist, Psalm 91 that we read today, this out loud this morning, we must be those who celebrate God's grace, but also putting on our buckler and shield to face those things, those people who will test us and the teachings of Christ, of how to love, be merciful, forgiving, and kind to one another. These are not just platitudes. These are things that we must impart, do in our own lives to be a reflection of Jesus Christ. Let us be that way. Let us not think of the torturous things that a martyr goes through. Think of the kingdom of God that awaits us with the crown of victory. Let us now stand and let us offer our prayers as people of God, turning to page 388 in your Book of Common Prayer, page 388. The response is, hear our prayer. Prayers of the People, Form 4. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours. Grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles. Bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Are there other prayers that you would like to offer this day in name or those events that are going on around us? Whitney Bechtel, she works as preparing her father's funeral this Saturday. John McCracken, as he continues to heal from his concussion, for his family. Reverend Nick Yeager. Pray for peace in our world, especially in Ukraine, the end of war. Pray for peaceful dialogue between politicians in our United States in this election time. respect and dignity. Pray and give thanks for all those celebrating birthdays and wedding anniversaries this week. We especially would pray for those who we remember this week, especially for John Krause, John Shadle, Molly Desmutes, those couples celebrating their gift of love and friendship for their wedding anniversaries, especially for Charlene and John Baker, and for Lindsay and David Black. May they celebrate the gift of life and love. And for all of those we know in our personal lives who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries. Give thanks, Almighty God. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you. Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church, and give us the peace that and unity that your heavenly city, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, now and forever. Amen.
Amen."
Let us now ask God for forgiveness in those times when we have failed to be kind to one another and to our God. Let us confess our sins to God and our neighbor. We are on page 360 in your Book of Common Prayer, page 360. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone.
We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves.
We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent.
For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ,
have mercy on us and forgive us,
that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways
to the glory of your name.
Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all of your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Please stand. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us extend to each other a sign of Christ's peace. God's peace be with you all.
The Lord.
Peace.
Charles.
God's peace be with you all. I have a few announcements. Just to remind you that Empty Bowls Project is this Saturday from 11:30 to 2 p.m. at the Paducah Convention Center. It is a wonderful way to support the hungry of our community and also receive a wonderful keepsake pottery bowl. I'll be going on retreat starting Friday of this week, and I'll be returning next Wednesday. Father Kempton Baldridge will be leading service next Wednesday for me in my absence, and Martha Huggins will be leading morning prayer this Sunday. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a sacrifice unto God. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through the great shepherd of your flock, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who after his resurrection sent forth his apostles to preach the gospel and to teach all nations, and promised to be with them always, even to the end of the ages. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father,
we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, O gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. The fullness of time put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where, with Bartholomew and all of your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Psalter. Because of new CDC guidelines, I am offering the common cup if you'd like to receive from it, also from the cup of intention as well. I will distribute the bread first and then the cup. All are welcome. God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son, that all who believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. John chapter 3, verse 16. Let us offer our prayer after Holy Communion, found on page 365 in your Book of Common Prayer, page 365. Please stand. Let us pray. Eternal God,
Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let us Let's go forth and be the church. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.